Hello, and welcome to another Scriptcase tutorial. Today we're going to be looking at SMS notifications and sending them inside of your Scriptcase application. My name is Nate Carpenter, and I'm going to be walking you through this demonstration. I hope this is helpful for you. I hope you learn a lot. Let's get started. So we're starting here in the Scriptcase documentation, and the reason we're starting here is I want to show you the basics of what it is to send an SMS message inside of Scriptcase. Scriptcase has made it very easy for us with this little macro right here. This is the SE send SMS macro. And you can look this up for yourself in the documentation if you want later. But here it is. And basically, we just need to give it an array of settings and then tell it to send. So in that array is the information about the message itself. So the message and the to number. And then the second array in that array of settings is the gateway and the authentication token. So we're going to be learning how to use it with this Clickatell API. And when you use that, it gives you an authentication token like this. So let's go over to Clickatell and see how we would get that set up. So I've got it open here. It's clickatell.com. And you can go and sign up and create an account. I already have one, so I'm going to go over to this tab. And here I have it. So what you need to do is set up an SMS API here. So if you want to, once you get into your account, you can go over to Get Started with SMS right here. And you need to set up a test phone. And if you haven't done that, it's pretty easy. Just set up the phone number that you want to use this with. You can text for free to those test phones. And then once you want to add it for all phones, it will start charging you. And then you need to create an SMS integration. I already have a couple here, but I'm going to walk through the process for you here. So we're going to go create new integration here. And we can name it whatever we want. So I'm going to call it SE Demo. And it's going to be a sandbox environment. And we're going to choose a REST API. And these features, we can change them if we want. We can make it just a standard delivery type, make two-way messaging if that's something you want set up, and then click Next. So you can change those if you want. There's a whole bunch of more settings here. And this is all individualized to whatever your needs would be. I'm going to leave these on the defaults right now. But you could enable, you know, different parts to be sent, converting numbers, all of that. And these settings can be changed after you set up the integration as well. So click Next. And then you can attach your test phone numbers to it. So I have mine set up here. And that's all checked and everything. And then I'm going to click Next again. Gives us an overview. And we're going to finish it. Okay, so we've created our test integration, and if we scroll down here, we see it right here, SE Demo. So let's click on that. So here we have our information, and here's our API key that's going to serve as our authentication token inside of Scriptcase. So now, let's go into inside of Scriptcase and create a blank application that sends a basic text. So we'll go over here to Scriptcase. This is my development environment. We're going to create a new blank application. So here it is. And it's a blank application. Here we go. We can call it SMS demo like that. And we're going to click create on that. Okay. And if you're unfamiliar with a blank application, it's just a place to put whatever code you want. It's completely customizable to whatever you need. So it's very easy for this type of demonstration, where we just want to send a basic SMS. We don't want anything fancy or complicated. So let's go back to the Scriptcase documentation and copy that code. So here it is right here. And I'm going to copy that. Okay, so we've got this code copied, and we need to change the to phone number, the message if we want to, and then the authentication token. So let me get my phone number here, and because this is an American phone number, I'm going to preface it with 1. And then let's change the message to something unique. And then we need to get this authentication token from Clickatell. So let's go back over here to our Clickatell API, copy that API key, and paste it in right here. And here we have it all set up. So let's go ahead and run this. And we didn't put any messaging in, but we'll put that in just a little bit. So it's loaded, so it should have sent it. So let's go over to Google Voice is what I'm using for SMS. And here we have our text. And that's what we sent. So that works. That's pretty easy to set up. You can do a lot with that very easily. Let's throw a little bit of a message in for our users just to see how that works. So after it sends, we can just do SE alert, which is just going to pop up an alert. Like that. And then we can use the new Sweetwater alerts with Scriptcase 9.4 to make it look even nicer. This is just extra. So I'm going to go to Applications here and Settings. And we're going to check the Use Sweetwater Alert mode. And so that'll pop up a nice looking message. You, of course, don't have to do that, but it makes it look a little bit nicer. Let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. Okay, so we've got a nice little message here. It says message sent. And here is our message. Okay, so now let's put this in a control application, and this will give us a little bit more functionality and might be a more realistic test case for your development purposes. So we're going to create a new application. This is going to be a control application once this loads. Here we go. Let's name it SMS Control Demo is what I'm going to name it. Let's click Create. And what we want for this is a phone number that the user can input and a message that the user can input. So we're going to create two fields. So we'll go over here to Fields, Create Field, and we're going to choose two of them. Let's click Next, like so. And the first one's going to be a phone field, like so. And the next one is going to be the message. So we want it to be multiple lines of text, like so. And let's click Create. Okay, so we've got our two fields. Let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like for now. Just getting the UI set up, so it's loading here. Okay, so we've got our phone field and we've got our message field. And this can be expanded to fit any size. And you could, of course, put a text limit on this so they couldn't go over the size of a SMS message if you wanted to. Let's go in the phone field and let's put a mask in. And we're going to go ahead and set up a field mask to help the user input the phone number in the correct format. Now, this is a US phone number, so I'm going to set it up with a traditional 9-digit phone number. And what we need to do for that is we can just put all X's in, like that. Let's hit save on that. And we're not going to allow it to be prefixed with the country code because we're going to do that ourselves behind the scenes in just a second. But then we want to make sure that they only put in numbers. So we're going to go to values format, allowed characters here. I'm going to choose the selected ones. And we're going to unselect all these except numbers like this. So only the numbers are selected, so they can only input integers. And then let's go ahead and run this. So it looks pretty much the same, but if I try to type in letters, it won't work because the field map, because it's blocking that. And if I try to type in more than 9 characters, it won't work. So if I try to put in a phone number, like that, it works. But if I try to type another one, it does not. Okay, so that's all set up. So now let's add the code behind the scenes to make this work. So let's go back to our Scriptcase environment. We're going to copy this code from our blank application. So let's go back and get it here. Just grab all that and copy it. And we're going to go to our control application, events, and the onValidate success event. So this is after all the fields have been validated and the data is correct, then we execute this code. So we put it in here and we just need to replace it a little bit. So instead of hard coding the number, we're still going to leave the country code in there, but we're going to concatenate it with the phone field. So we called that ph, so we just put it inside the curly braces and it will get the value out of the phone field. And then we need to replace the message with the message that the user entered. So same type of thing. We're just putting the value from the message field in. The gateway and authentication tokens stay the same. And we're going to leave the alert up there to know that it was sent successfully. Let's go ahead and save that. And let's make that a nice looking Sweetwater alert as well. So we're going to go to Application, Settings, scroll down to the bottom here, and the Use Sweetwater Alerts right here. Okay, so let's go ahead and run this and see if it works. So we're going to run it. And wait for it to load here. Okay, let me get my test phone number in. And just a reminder, this has to be one of the phone numbers that you've added as a test phone number inside of Clickatel and attached to your SMS integration. Let's expand this and type a message. Okay, and let's click OK on this, and this should send our message. Okay, and the message was sent, it said. Now let's go and see if we got a message. Here we did. And that's the message we sent, so that works. So that's how to send a basic message in a blank application, and then in a control application where you control the message and the phone number. So now let's look at an application that's already inside of the samples project. So if you noticed, I'm working inside of the samples project in my Scriptcase development environment. This is a project that comes preloaded with your development environment. And so it's accessible to everyone who has Scriptcase. You can add it as one of your projects. And it has a lot of examples in it that are very useful. And we're going to look at one of those. So we're going to go back to our home here. We're going to look in our V9 folder here on the left. And we're going to look at 9.2. And in that, we have an application called Control SMS Group. And this application sends a whole bunch of messages to a whole bunch of people inside of your database. So let's go ahead and run this and see what it looks like. So it's loading here. Okay, so this is a pretty advanced control application, and it's already set up inside of your samples project. Here you can select a group. This is from like a customers table. And so you have different kind of regions here. So you could send messages only to one region, like that. You can choose which gateway, which we only have Clickatel set up right now. You can schedule it for some time out in the future, and you can set a validity period. And then you type in your message here, hit send, and it will send it. And the cool thing about this is it'll give you a status report back from Clickatel on every message that was sent. So let's go ahead and try and send one of these and see what it looks like. I'm going to choose New England here and type in a message. And we'll go ahead and send this. And here we have a nice table set up here. And one of the messages is sent successfully, and the rest of them failed. And it gives us the error message. It was too short. Gives us the error code. So then we can do some troubleshooting and figure out what is wrong with those numbers. So let's look at this code and figure out how this is done. So let's go back here to our control application inside of Scriptcase. Let's go to events. And let's go to the onload event. Here we have just switching out some of the UI things. So we're adding in a style sheet, changing some colors on things, and disabling some fields here. And this is just if the user selects a checkbox here that we saw right here. This checkbox, it enables and disables some fields like so. So that's just controlling some UI stuff. It's nothing too complicated, and it's not quite what we're concerned about here. We want to see how it sends the messages. So we go here to the onValidate success event. And here it's getting values out of the user selection. So it's getting the gateway out and the message out. Those are the field names there. And then it's looking at the send type. And if it's sending to a group, this option right here, then we're going to select all the customers out of our database. So we've got that region ID. We're just limiting that query. getting the phone and contact name. It executes that query, and then it does this loop to get all the phone numbers out of that query, out of that result, and put them in an array of phone numbers. And then it's going to do this for the, since we chose the Clickatell gateway, and that's the only one we have set up. We choose a location token, and then we choose the from number here, and then we pass all that information into this function here, the SMS Clickatell function. This is a custom function that is only in this application. So let's go ahead and look at that. So we're going to go to programming here on the left, and then PHP methods. And there it is. So this looks kind of like our previous code to send a message. We've got a configuration array here, but we've got a few more options here. For one, we've got the array of numbers here. That's all loaded up and it can send the multiple numbers. We've got the from number, binary, the schedule time, the validity period, char set, message. These are all settings that you can use if you want to use them. And then of course the gateway we define, which is Clickatell. And then, of course, the location token, which is going to be our authentication token from Clickatell. And then, down here, it just sends that. It unsets the scheduled delivery time if we don't use that. But then it just sends the message using the scsendSMS macro and gets the return from that here. And with that return, then, it gives us our output. So it creates a nice table here that's very easy to read with some headings and then the data then below it. And that gets output on screen. It returns that there and then back in our onValidate success. We get that return here and set it equal to this field on screen. So that's how we get this table right here that's formatted nicely and allows us to see any errors that occurred. So that's how you send an SMS message using the Clickatell API inside of a Scriptcase application. I hope you see how Scriptcase does a lot of the work for us as developers. It makes things a lot easier so that we don't have to do a lot of work integrating the API. We can simply start sending messages.